Jon Jones vacating his UFC light heavyweight title, then kind of hinting in retirement, and then saying, nah, we're all good, I'm actually moving to heavyweight within a few hours. What up, Fightful fam? Shakiel Mahjouri here with your Fightful Fix, August 18th, 2020 edition. We're going to react to Jon Jones vacating his UFC light heavyweight title, then kind of hinting in retirement, and then saying, nah, we're all good, I'm actually moving to heavyweight within a few hours, as well as the potential for Michael Chandler to move to the UFC after UFC President Dana White said he is down to meet with him. Okay, but first, before we get started, if you don't mind clicking subscribe and tapping the notification bell, that goes such a long way into helping this channel grow and supporting all the wonderful work we're doing here. A like on the video ain't too shabby either. Okay, first, former UFC light heavyweight champion Jon Jones announced that he would be vacating the belt, and that he suggested basically that he was retiring for the foreseeable future because he could not reach a deal with the UFC to move to heavyweight. It's been pretty publicly stated for a while now that Jon Jones and the UFC are very far apart at the negotiation table. Jon Jones wants a significant raise to make the risky move up a division. The UFC was not playing ball. That's basically what Jon said in his tweet. He says, hey, the UFC doesn't want to negotiate, so I'm out. Peace. But I'll stay in the testing pool. I'll continue to train for the next X number of months or year, whatever it may have been, in good faith. Later the same day, Jones updates a tweet saying, hey, you know what? It's actually looking pretty good now, so I am going to prepare for my heavyweight debut. Dana White has made it very, very clear that what is next for Stipe Miocic is Francis Ngannou. So where does that leave Jon Jones? I'm going to hope that Daniel Cormier is truly staying retired. I know that a fight with Jon Jones at heavyweight is something he's interested in, but DC, man, you've had an incredible career. I think there isn't a whole lot left for him to prove, period. And that leaves Jon Jones in an interesting predicament. Now, let's say he could wait for the winner of Francis Ngannou versus Stipe Miocic, but who knows when that fight is really going to materialize. I didn't read the article, but I saw that Stipe Miocic was at the top of the medical suspension list coming out of UFC 252. Now, if you want to do something soon, there's always the option for an interim title fight between Francis Ngannou versus Jon Jones. I think that's something Luke Thomas might be interested in, but for me personally, I'm sure there are other tantalizing fights, and I really don't think that I want to see Ngannou, the powerful, hulking Ngannou, as the first test for Jon Jones, but there are some good options. I think the most high-profile fight you could do outside of Miocic or Ngannou is probably Derek Lewis. Ultra popular, very dangerous, hard to keep grounded, but probably someone that Jones could have an easier time navigating around than Ngannou, who I think is a little bit quicker and a little bit more powerful. Another fight I think we could see for Jon Jones is Jarzinho Rozenstruik, someone who again has separate you from consciousness power, but in the JDS and Alistair Overeem fights, I'd argue, was being outstruck in both up until the finish. I don't really know what else to say about this craziness. I think Jon Jones to heavyweight is huge, especially because it opens up a lot of possibilities for the rest of the light heavyweight division. Brett Okamoto of ESPN reported that Dominic Reyes and Jan Blachowicz will be fighting soon, both very, very highly ranked 205ers, and now I wouldn't be surprised if that fight was for the light heavyweight title. Additionally, you have Thiago Santos versus Glover Teixeira coming up, and that should without a doubt be for the next number one contender to fight the winner of Reyes Blachowicz, should that Reyes Blachowicz fight be for the title. You're giving a great opportunity for either the young rising star Dominic Reyes to be your champion, or the wily veteran who's on a mean streak in Jan Blachowicz to be a champion. You're also giving a really great opportunity for some older guys in that division, the likes of Anthony Smith, the likes of Thiago Santos, and definitely Glover Teixeira, who I think is my sentimental favorite to win a title, because man, that guy is just so good at his age. I desperately want to see him go out with the title. But it gives a chance for these older guys who've been held down in a division ruled by Jon Jones to have a really, really, really good shot at winning the light heavyweight strap. And man, if Alistair Gustafsson wasn't on the cold run that he is right now, it would have been so, so, so great to finally see the Swede as UFC champion. Anyway, if I had it my way, Reyes versus Blachowicz for the title, give the next title shot to the winner of Santos versus Teixeira, and then you got some really interesting developments in the division between the Anthony Smith versus Alexander Rachich winner, the sudden rise of Jiří Prochazka, and an upcoming fight between Ryan Spann and Johnny Walker that should be super, super interesting. All right, and as we wrap up, let's move on to something that I am so into, which is the possibility of Michael Chandler making the jump from Bellator to the UFC. Chandler knocks out Benson Henderson in round one of their recent fight. Enters the free agency circuit, and Dana White told, I think it was John Morgan of MMA Junkie at the UFC 252 post-fight presser, that Michael Chandler deserves a shot in the UFC, and that Dana would definitely sit down and speak with Michael Chandler. That is huge news to me. I remember Eddie Alvarez's jump being such a big deal, and I mean, look what happened. I know Eddie Alvarez did not have the most successful UFC run, but the man is a former UFC champion. He beat Justin Gaethje. He beat Rafael Dos Anjos. Like, that was such an incredible run and really cool to see the Underground King succeed. And that's what we love to see, right? We love to see when these guys that come from promotions like Bellator, one championship at the time, Strikeforce, prove that they are not just the best in their company, that they're the best in MMA, period. And Michael Chandler is good enough to deserve a shot in the UFC. The only person I'd arguably want to see more fight UFC competition is Douglas Lima, because that man at welterweight is an absolute beast. Now, in terms of what I'd like to see from Michael Chandler, I discussed this in a previous Fightful Fix, but I think Paul Felder is without a doubt the best opening fight for him. Someone who's immediately going to test him, immediately going to sort of assess him and where he stands in the UFC. And a win for Chandler in that fight would immediately put him in a prime position to fight a top five guy. And that is all for today's Fightful Fix. Let me know in the comments section, who would you most like to see win the UFC light heavyweight title over the next couple of years? And additionally, who do you think Jon Jones' first fight should be at heavyweight? If you enjoyed this video, again, the best way you can help the channel grow is by clicking subscribe, tapping the notification bell, and the like button ain't too bad either. For Fightful MMA, I'm Shakiel Mahjouri, and we'll catch you next time.